Hello everyone and welcome to DI Health Advice, and in this video we will discuss basics of dental implants, learn more about the latest research regarding the antibacterial coating which is developed to avoid the infections in the dental implants. We will also discuss the risk of dental implants and post-surgery care. So let's begin. First of all, let's understand what are dental implants. Dental implants are used to replace the natural tooth in case of tooth loss. The implants can replace single or multiple teeth depending on the condition of the patient. Dental implants are ideal to replace lost teeth due to accidents or any other disease. It is a titanium fixture that is inserted into the jawbone in place of the root of the old tooth, and then an artificial tooth is erected over the implant. Basically, it is a method of constructing an entirely new tooth with roots like a natural tooth. Now the question arises, why titanium? Titanium is a special metal which is biocompatible. It means it can be accepted by our body, and over the time our jawbone fuses with it, making the implant feel and behave almost like a natural tooth. So who can have dental implants? Anyone healthy enough to undergo tooth extraction can go for dental implants. Dentists examine the condition of a patient with CT scans or x-rays and do a complete dental evaluation to understand if a patient can go for dental implants or not. Maintaining good oral hygiene is mandatory, and non-existence of disease like diabetes may be required. In short, only dentists can diagnose and tell if a person can go for dental implants or not. So now let's talk about the latest research in this field. The University of the Basque Country, Spain, have developed a coating that can prevent bacterial infection and neutralize it if needed. This can be a major breakthrough in the field of dental implants, because about 10% of dental implants fail because of bacterial infections, and this new technology is built to stop that. So let's see how it works and how it can benefit you. The major reason of bacterial infections in the dental implants is the growth of bacteria in the fixtures. So scientists have come up with an idea of covering the fixtures with an antibacterial coating which does not let bacteria to come in contact with the fixtures and also not affect the proper integration of the implant into the jawbones. So once the jawbone is properly fused with the dental implants, the coating wears away. For this technology, the research team used the sol gel synthesis with silica as the precursor. Sol gel synthesis is used for the fabrication of oxides of titanium. We have already discussed that dental implants are made up of titanium, that's why they use sol gel synthesis. Silica is known to be osteoinductive, which basically means that it can aid in bone healing process, so that's why it is used. So there are different kinds of coating under consideration. The first one will have a very long degradation period, which will cover the implants till it is properly fused with the jawbone. In this case, bacteria will not reach the implants till it is properly healed. The second method will have a short degradation period, and it will have an antibacterial solution that will be released very soon to kill the bacterial infection. There is still a lot to be done to actually implement such technologies, but as you already know, that the technology is progressing at a very fast pace and these coatings may be available in future. So if you are considering dental implants, then you should inquire from your dentist about these antibacterial coatings. Now let's have a look at the risk of dental implants. Risk includes bone fracturing at the implant site, damage to tooth root, and you may need root canal treatment to cure the damage. Nerve damage in case of lower jaw dental implants, because the surgery site is usually quite close to a sensory nerve. The damage can cause numbness or tingling in lips and chin. There is also a probability of sinus infection in case of upper jaw implants. But the good news is, most of these problems can be treated with proper medication and can be healed with time. There are some other problems related to surgery, such as failure of the implant to lock in, fracture of implant parts, and fracture of the artificial tooth. All these problems can be rectified by an additional surgery for replacing the defected part. Do remember that an additional fee may be charged to repair or replace a failed dental implant. Post-surgery side effects include bruising, swelling, bleeding, and soreness, but these can be treated with medications. Now let's have a look at the post-dental implants care. Post-operative care is pretty basic. Follow the instructions of your dentist, maintain good oral hygiene, take your medications on time, and visit your dentist for regular checkups. Lastly, I want to conclude this by saying that dental implants can be a very good option for the people who have lost their teeth and want their artificial teeth to look and feel like natural. So this is all I wanted to share with you for now. If you liked this video, then click on that like button. Also share this video with your friends and family and subscribe for more health updates, home remedies and health news. Thanks for watching.